Hello, welcome to All Things Venus. This is Aishwarya. Sharing with you all today a Ugadi look inspired by very beautiful Nayanthara. To me, it looks simple, pretty and traditional. We're gonna go through the skin prep for dry skin and how to cheat our eyebrow shape, how to do this beautiful, neutral, chocolatey kind of an eyeshadow. And I feel like this is the look I can wear and sit in a puja. First things first, it's really important to clean your facial hair. I've made like a full video on how to shave and everything. And it's done. Now let's clean the brows. The video I made on how to remove facial hair also has details on how to do the brows and everything. You guys can go check that out. I'll put the link somewhere here, or I'll put it at the end of this video. How we can, how to do threading, how we can do shaving, how we can do plucking. I'm gonna moisturize the heck out of my face because what she's wearing is a demi matte. And the thing with demi matte on dry skin is that you can wear it, but it has to be very well moisturized. Take it with your fingers, spread it all over your face. Just like that. So while that moisturizer is setting, let's do our brows. This is by Passion Indulgio, and it is made with all natural ingredients. Earlier, I was using pure soap. And then I thought, I don't know if putting pure soap all day in my brows is a good thing or not. So now I've moved on to this. You can see the difference there. A moisturizer on top of the Snail Mucin. Another thing I like to do is I like to just put some lip balm on my lip. By the time I finish everything, the lips would be ready for the lip liner. This is the sunscreen, and I have seen that it also works as a good base for foundation. My dog's here, guys.
What's up, Bobby?
Hey guys, current is gone and I was very, very exhausted from wearing that very heavy sari. So I'm wearing a similar color to me now. Rimmel Lasting Finish Primer. This primer is really good for dry skin. So this is what the shade looks like. This powder, this is by K Beauty. It's like a small, this kind of a thing. And this is a net inside. So I'm just taking a little bit, that much. This is what the shade looks like. Ooh. I can see a lot of it coming to the air. It's very finely milled. Set the eye. This is the first time I'm using this powder, so I'll let you know a review on it. Would you be interested in a review on this K Beauty banana powder? Her eyeshadow right now looks to me like a soft matte brown. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna take this transition shade. Now I'm taking a little bit of this brown. Okay, so she's not wearing a smoky eye. We're going to be very careful not to smoke it out. But just create a soft brown kind of a look. You can do this with any palette, guys. I have shown this one because this is easily available everywhere. Over here, the bright yellow. I'm going to run it underneath the brow. This really gives such a good, fully finished kind of a look, It gives a good finishing to your brow as well. Everything looks well blended. And I'm gonna apply that in the center of the lid. Because if you really notice closely, the center of her lids are of skin color. Using faces coal to tight line. Her coal is like fully running from here to here. So that's what we're also going to do. I've made a video on three ways to tight line. You guys can go check that out. I'm going to tight line and be right back. And if you really notice, like the upper and lower line is joined. I don't know if it's because she's smiling or if they've actually joined it. Just smudge this. Like it looks like she's not wearing liner outside at all, but she is. It's just that it's very evenly smudged. You're not able to make out as all. Gonna apply this Lash Craft mascara by Sephora, and as always I'm taking a empty mascara brush. This is my favorite. It is Max Factor masterpiece. The wand is so beautiful. Gonna use this to separate and fan out all the lashes. You can see how many bristles that wand has, and yet it's like very smooth and soft, never pokes the eye.
You know what? We forgot to line the brows. Let's just do the brows. So I'm using the 3-point technique. Her eyebrows are quite short, so I'm going to like shorten mine as well. Straight and then a drop. Try and remove my natural arch. And I'm just going to like make it straight like hers.
Drawing a straight line, trying my best here to get as close as I can to her eyebrow shape.
Gonna apply the shade Golden in Maybelline Fit Me. Now, one thing I do to get full coverage from concealer is I apply it and then I leave it on for some time. From what I'm seeing in the picture, to me, it looks like she's wearing full coverage foundation. I'm gonna let that sit for a while. Let's do the foundation. Using Maybelline Fit Me. I wish it came with a pump, guys. So I'm gonna take about that much. That's the color. Oh, my head was aching with all that hair tied up. So my hair is loose now, don't mind about the continuity. I am going to use a flat foundation brush because in the picture you can tell that she's wearing, I'm looking at a picture right now and she's wearing full coverage. Now, an easy way to get the fullest coverage from your foundation is just switch your tools, okay? A sponge will give you a good natural finishing coverage, whereas a brush, especially a flat synthetic brush, will give you the fullest coverage possible. And apply it like that, apply it like that, apply it like that, apply it like that. Okay, let's get to blending. This is a yellow undertone foundation. Can you see the color of the foundation is a little yellow, and the color of the concealer, it has a little bit of peach undertone, which is what you need, because the peach really cancels out the ash. Yellow also does, but peach does it a little bit better. Let's just blend it here, because I hate it when there's one nude patch left here. When you're doing full coverage, it's very important to get this part of your nose as well. Otherwise, what happens is there's foundation everywhere, and there's this, you know, a patch left here that just looks really unblended. I'm just taking a wet sponge and bouncing it all over my skin just to make it blend, because this is a matte foundation, right? So it's not sitting very well on my skin. I need like smoothening, dewy foundations. Taking K Beauty powder, banana. Setting it. So that's what it did. That it immediately made everything matte and it feels very light. Like I'm not feeling like I'm wearing a lot of powder or anything. It's like that. That's the color. I'll just show you here. Yeah. So I'm gonna mix this and this. Mix both the colors really well. Yeah, hers is looking a little more like pinky. What I'm wearing is looking a little bit more peachy. So I'm gonna like just go and grab this one thing. And it's like this pink. And this is the shade. So we're gonna mix this as well. Because what she's wearing is like a little more pinky. Okay. I think I've come close to that. And it looks like she's either wearing a transparent gloss or a balm or something over it. Her blush placement is beautiful. Her blush placement is on the apple of the cheekbone, which is a very old school placement. I haven't seen anybody on YouTube do this lately, but it just makes, you know, your cheekbones look very yummy. I mean, people these days are talking about placing the blush over here as opposed to here, because if you place it here, it looks like, you know, your face is pulled up when you place the blush here and you contour. But she's not contoured and there's no bronzing there either. It's just blush placed like that. Let's do that. As far as I can tell, this is the color she's wearing. This is Creamy Cinnamon by Maybelline. Cheeky Glow. So I'm just taking an angular brush and I'm just blush like so. See the difference? A little bit of blush, guys. Just that little bit makes such a difference. This just looks like more natural. And no Indian look is complete without a bindi. So she's wearing a small black bindi. Let's accessorize. I can wear silver, but my sari blouse has some bronze work in it. So instead of silver, I'm gonna go for bronze. I feel like this will match better. And she's wearing like really big, beautiful, chunky earrings. And I think what she has is a side partition. And her hair, I think what they've done for her hair is, okay, this hair is gone back like this and left it like that. This hair is also gone back. And then they've taken a little bit of hair from here and just placed it like this. That's what they've done. And that's how she has that little bit of like volume over here. I absolutely love the way this look came out. Go check out my other videos as well and subscribe for good vibes and highlighted skin. And most important of all, it's just makeup. Don't stress about it. At the end of the day, it washes off. You do you.